Hello. We put 50 rounds to the magazine. No problems with the magazine. I have one issue, but I don't think it was the magazine. I don't have a standard magazine for the 43 with me. I left that one at home. This is the plus one Pierce. This is the plus two Turan. And this is the ETS 12 round. You can see the difference in size. Gives you something to hold while you're shooting too. So this is the Turan Pierce. And this is the Turan. This is the Pierce. And this is the new ETS. So far so good. It's nice to have in the back pocket. You know, it still gives you the option of carrying ultimately concealed. The 43 is probably the best real carry gun available to you. I mean, you can carry anything. I carry Smith & Wesson 500. I got this thin summer shirt on. You can't even see my 19 there. So the 43 disappears. But when I had this in my back pocket, get in the gym, you got to go to your second mag and have 12 rounds instead of 6. So that's a nice thing to have. But I haven't had any real magazine problems. But I don't think I've ever had an issue with 43. I have to look at all my videos. I made so many. But because I don't pay much attention to them. You know, when you're a copper over 25 years and you're shooting on the range all the time, I used to shoot on the range all the time. And if anything happened, I just dealt with it automatically and kept on shooting. So it's not a memory thing for me. The memory part's clear and they're going to keep shooting. So jams don't bother me any, but I very rarely have them. But I'm using the cheap ammo, $9.97 at Walmart, Federal. So, may have been an ammo issue, may have been me not keeping it properly. Who knows? But I cleared it and kept shooting. That's the matter. So it's just nice because you compartmentalize or modulize your system. You got the little 43 that carries so easily and is real compatible with a lot of different, like summer dress here. I could have been wearing my shorts too. But I don't know if I'd get on the ground today, so I brought my longer pants. But it gives you that option. And you have the extra magazine. And if you really need some hardware, you can carry this other small ones in your side pockets. Like I get the shorts with the little flap pockets. Never put the gun in there. It beats against your knee when you're walking and you can't get to it. If you have those hip, you know, pants and your shorts, like those khakis, it's hard to get to and get it out quick. Because if you can't engage, the gun's no good. I don't care what it is or how many rounds you have. So, remember, gunfighting, fighting is the key word. Most of the time, you get asked to any street cop, to get to your gun, you have to fight first to get clearance. Because those guys will engage you up close. They don't stand 2 blocks down the road and go, "Hey, I'm a bad guy, get your gun out, I'm coming." It doesn't work that way, okay? And like today, me not feeling in tip-top shape today, doesn't matter. 25 years in the street, I've had the flus, I've had to testify in court all day after working all night. I'm so tired I couldn't see straight. That's when stuff happens. Shit happens when you're not ready. So that's why I train on the coldest days, the tiredest days, laid in the water in a thunderstorm. Because when I get in that stuff, if ever, hope I don't, then it's old home week. It's not something like, ooh, I'm afraid. Okay? So if it's more familiar to you, just react normally and just keep on rolling. Because I don't care what kind of plans you have, it just doesn't seem to work out there. At least it really ticked me off when a dispatcher would send me on a hot call and say, no weapons involved. That would really give me a case of the red butt. Meaning no weapons involved. They got meat cleavers, knives, baseball bats. But most of the time they said that, every weapon you can think of, sure was a nuclear weapon they had. So always be ready for everything that you're not ready for, and you'll be okay. Let's go shoot. Okay, we got one in the tube this time. And 12 of the magazine. See how it feels when it's fully stuffed in a magazine? And they got one of the two. So I got 13 rounds now, which is the capacity if you use it. Now, if you're using it as a backup mag, you're only going to have 12 because you're going to empty the gun before you switch, right? So let me go mark those holes. Those last holes I was just shooting to see if it works. I wasn't shooting for accuracy. Now we're going to do some movie theater shooting. This is 15 yards, and this is about across all the front seats on the big theater. The guy just came around the corner. I'm sitting in my usual front row seat.
This is going to be about 15 yards. Now, if you're up higher in the rows, this could be higher. We'll shoot that in a minute. I'm testing the new magazine, the main gist here. So I'm assuming that's body armor. Comes around the corner, looks kind of big in the chest. So from 15 yards, and he's leaning, he's shooting over top of that little wall that usually comes down there by the steps of the theater. So all I have is his head to shoot at. Okay, looks like three shots in the head, shoot three more. All right, shoot three more. That was more than three. Shoot a few more. All right. That's like shooting across the whole set of front rows, popping them. Okay, I got about 50-50 at that speed. I got loaded with 12. I got a little thumb relief thing, but I haven't had to use it. I'm surprised. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This is nice. You can count them real quick. And there's one in the chamber. It goes right in the locks quick. So this time, I'm going to shoot from all the way up in the corner like you're in the higher seats. So from here, 25 yards. I'll shoot a little faster just to see on the head how many rounds you can get on them. See here. Whoops. First missed feed I've ever had with the 43. Now that wouldn't be in the magazine because it already fired. That's the first mishap I had. Probably the ammo. I've had trouble with the federal ammo lately. I didn't used to have trouble at all. Probably the ammo. We're going to shoot 100 rounds. We'll see if it happens again with this ammo. Okay, so far, I think the magazine's okay. I think the stovepipe there didn't make it all the way to a stovepipe. Probably the ammo. Could have been me. But you'll notice, last time I was here, like today, I'm not feeling very good. That's why I came to shoot. I always like to shoot when things are rough. Last time I shot 2 weeks ago, I believe, was a thunderstorm. And I shot during a thunderstorm, laying on the ground in the water in the mud. I've been out here when it's like 0, 10 degrees. That's how you test yourself. But you'll notice when that happens, I don't even miss a beat. Half a second later, I'm shooting again. Because stuff happens out here. And I don't think that's a magazine problem. I don't think it's ever happened with the other magazines. I got so many guns I can't remember. But I don't think so. So I was shooting a little faster. Alright, let's see here. I'm just gonna shoot through this. This is the first box. It'd be 50. But I don't think it's a magazine problem. Let's walk back up here. I'll shoot close and see what happens. We'll shoot from 15 again. Just like shooting across the theater from here. Okay, from here. All right, working good. Yeah, I don't think it's a magazine problem last time. One in the chamber, 12 in the magazine. All right. Let me grab this chair right here. My theater chair. Just went to see Wonder Woman last night. I'm a little bit disappointed. They tried to make it a serious Wonder Woman, but at the same time, stories that were kind of silly. But so we'll do the 15-yard seat in my chair, right here. You can see it right there. Okay, but all in all, it wasn't that bad of a movie. but I was a little bit disappointed. So I'm here minding my own business in the movie theater. Guy pops out and I see him pulling a rifle up over that wall where the steps comes down. This is all the way across the road, so people are here. So I've got to lean forward into the aisle to shoot past these people. Okay? Same thing, headshots. Okay, that's 6 headshots. Because the bottom of his body's covered, he got armor on. The only thing I got left to shoot. Looks like those are all in.
Okay, those are all in.
My theater chair here. So let's do it again. I'm sitting here facing the screen. That's where the wall is, where the people come around to come into the seats. And this is the walkway right in front of me. And then my favorite, right in the center of the screen seat, which is actually where I normally sit. I'm gonna go to where I normally sit. I normally sit in the center of the screen, which would be about right here. And that's the corner where they'd walk around and come in to get their seats. So I'm normally here. This is more like 8-9 yards maybe. Somewhere in that neighborhood. Again, there's people's heads along with mine. The right edge of that target. So there's nobody in front of me, there's just that walkway. So I lean away from the people and try again. Alrighty. Actually, when it was out. Okay, go reload. But the magazine's working good. So we'll be done. Well, I think I'm gonna end the theater shooting part and do something else just to practice with the magazine. Okay. Okay, take 2. Up here a little closer, we're going to talk about self-defense range and being effective and engaging. Now I'm not drawing from the holster, I got my 19 in here. I got a holster for it, but for right now I got a lot of shoots going on behind us and stuff. I just pretend like I'm drawing from the holster. You know, a lot of people, you know, that are doing the competition even right now, you know, they go draw from the holster, bring it to here. They push it out. That's a triangle. In real life, you don't have time to poke. Your feet might be like this when a guy comes. You may have to shoot like this. You think I'm kidding? I'm not. You might be going through something hazardous. You're stepping over something and the guy just pops out and you gotta go boom. I'll just show you. But if you just bring it from your holster, I shoot from here in this range. Boom, boom, boom. Bring it right in. So the time you get to here, push it out, I already hit him 3 times. Now people say when you're bowling, you can hit tables. Well, if there's a table, I won't do that. I'm not stupid. Hello. There's a table that I'm not going to hit. At the table, I'll pick it up and go over it quick as I can. I might put my hand right over the table and shoot. So, but I'm telling you, out in the street, it's not like a range. You got rules. You got targets, don't shoot back. You got targets, got a knife or gun, and he's shooting back, and he's in range to kill you. It's totally different. I don't care what kind of competition. I'm a long-time competitor. It's good for gun handling. I can switch, I can throw this gun hand to hand and shoot, boom, 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 but I won't do that. Like I said, a lot of people are here today. They're not here where I'm shooting,
but they're around. Competition's good, give you speed, accuracy, gun handling, but just like the guy who looks great in the gym, in the karate gym, goes out in a fight, when he gets hit, whole different story. Same thing here, if a guy hits you anywhere, same different story. You gotta be efficient. Your own purpose is to get the bullet out of here, put a slug in the bugger, period. So, how's it going? The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tell like I was stepping over something. Say you're going through a little stream or something like that, there's slippery rocks. You stepped over, and you get caught here, and the guy pulls out. Right in the ten ring. You're off balance. Say you're backing up, you're stumbling, the guy pulls out, you're in a worse position. Same thing. I'll show you the target in a wagon. Is this one running? Let me see. Okay, this one's running. I can show you right now.
You have some off position and all that kind of stuff.
Alrighty. So, you have to practice from whenever you can. Like I say, if you're coming out of the holster, I would shoot from here. Yeah, boom, boom, boom. Not as good as that, but putting bullets in the body. He'll be dropping the knife and dropping the gun, running or dying, one or the other. So instead of coming all the way up to here, all the way up to here, and you're in a good position like this. Now sometimes this position looks good for shooting, but if it gets by you, you don't get the gun out in time, and he rushes up the top, he can throw you over. If a guy's real close, you want to get in a fighting stance, he's real close. Instead of being here, you want to be here. Because from here, I can move, move, speed all around. If a guy charges me, he gets the shot out. But say he gets close, I can still push him off and I got bounced. When you're here, if he pushes you, you're going, then you're in those positions I was telling you about you want to avoid anyway. Like here, you know, that's nice. You pull it up, boom, headshot. Nice. But, if you're here, and you're moving, you say, headshot right next to that hole. This is movement, and that's in the competition stand. So, but you have to be able to adapt to whatever's happening right now. You can have ice, snow, that's why I was laying down last time. You might get hurt, you gotta pull up your left hand. Same thing. Oops, 13 rounds goes awful fast today. But you have to be adaptable. You gotta be putting the slugs in the bugger as soon as you can. I can show you right now. Okay, that's some off position and all that kind of stuff. Alrighty. So, you have to practice from whenever you can. Like I say, if you're coming out of the holster, I would shoot from here. You know, boom, boom, boom. Not as good as that, but it's putting bullets in the bugger. Decisions when you want to shoot. You'll see in the news, everybody and their mother has an opinion on cop shooting. They'll say, oh, we saw the video. That doesn't mean crap. If a guy's got a gun, let's give you different scenarios. I'm a guy who just shot three people in a club. And you're the cop and you contact me where the camera is. And I got my gun in my hand. Well, if you shoot me, I'm gonna say, well, he was pointing at you. Well, first of all, people, you know, sitting in the office, the only risk they take is choking on popcorn. A lot of gossiping about their fellow workers around the water cooler don't understand that if in this holster, I could draw faster than most people can react, the reaction time, and shoot them. If I had the gun holstered, they got a gun on me, much less in my hand. So if this guy has already shot people, he had a gun in his hand, and you say drop it, he doesn't drop it, you do what you want to do, but you might not make it. Right? Now I'm telling you this beforehand, so you know it's coming. Here, put your hands like this. Just clap fast as you can when you see me going to shoot you. Now that's easy, slap fast as you can as far as pulling your gun out or even shooting when you're over there. So if I'm here and the gun's not pointing towards you, you say drop the gun. I think I beat you. I beat him, he's dead. Same for here, drop the gun. Boom, right there, boom. Okay?
Wait,
the same, so you can't wait until he shoots. Because the guy can have him react quicker than you do. That's the whole point. If you're saying drop the gun, and he's like, I give up, stuff like that. Touch it. I give up, boom. That was a slow one there. Same thing. Same with love. We can go ahead, boom, boom. And he said, drop the gun. He shoots you, drop the gun, shoots you, drop the gun. So that's what I wanted to see. It's not all that easy making those decisions. The guy's got a gun, especially if he's already shot somebody. If he doesn't drop it, I don't know what to tell you. But if you don't know if he shot anybody, he still has a gun and he doesn't drop it. Remember, if you put a bullet in you, we're going to put a bullet in him. And if it's a tie, you both lose. And I don't want to lose in a tie or a flat out loser. Shooting's a deadly business.